Good morning. My name is the old mechanic. What I got here in my shed? A Yamaha VMAX from 1998. And I'm gonna do a bit of maintenance onto it. So I would say, come on over and we start. So guys, still busy on my Yamaha VMAX, a muscle bike. Yeah, it's a muscle bike. Today I'm gonna show you how you can do your own brake fluid change. That's very easy with my hints and tips as usual. First, be sure your reservoir level is horizontal. Then we're gonna push some brake fluid out. Got my canister, still old brake fluid in. We're gonna do this caliper. Now, let's see. Bakje for the rubber cap. You can't see it, but there's a camera. Okay. You need wrench 8. Give it first a quick smack. Hop hop. Okay. Put the hose onto the air screw. Okay. And then push it on so you get pressure on the caliper, and then open it. Blech. Before you open your reservoir, be sure to cover everything with towels. Brake fluid is very aggressive and you don't want to have that stuff on your paint or whatever. Then we need a Phillips screwdriver. Open the reservoir. A clean bakje thing. Iets. Oh, this is so easy. It's so easy. Hop. Then, always have to be careful. No, no. Whop. So, hop. We have here the oh my god, this hasn't been cleaned for quite a while. Not good, at least not for me. Gonna clean the edge. Hop. Come on over, show you something. This is great. This prevents the brake fluid from shooting out. So when you squeeze the brake lever a little bit too fast, your brake fluid is gonna shoot out. You don't want that to happen. So we're gonna suck the brake fluid out first. I have this one. I always suck out as much brake fluid as I can, as I don't want the old brake fluid mix with the new one. So see, that edge is really terrible, this one. So what I'm gonna do, I take some set, I can even see, feel it. I put a lot of paper in here and I'm gonna give this a sand, with some sanding paper, as this is, yeah, really terrible. I'm sure it starts to leak. Slightly bit more. I'm not easily satisfied. Should not go now. So now that's much better. Then that was grain 120. Now we take 1200. And then we give it a polish. So that's easy too. Wooden block. Actually, this is waterproof, so you need to put a little water. But not brand new, but okay. Take just the paper with a bit of W40. Nah. Guys, much and much better. For this bike, I'm gonna use my good old Castrol React Performance .4. Why? Because it's good, simply. And I use this one so I can easily get it in. I'm gonna put some more. Okay, there we start. Open, close again. Then fill it up again, a few times more, and then we go to the other side. That's easy to. So. Okay. Going to the other side. Carefully take your hose off. Pop up. Then, what I always do, now watch, tip from the old mechanic. As you know by now, brake fluid is very aggressive. And it, over time, it starts to corrode your bleeding screw. So what I do, I make this from a piece of my special toilet paper. And I slide it in. Okay. And now, it's gonna suck out all the brake fluid. Job done. Then we go to the other side. Get the rubber cap off. Easier. Yeah, it's so easy. Then we give it first a quick smackety smack. Okay. Then we take the hose and we push it onto the bleeding screw. It's also easy to be sure that it stays in place. Now, and over here we're gonna do the same. Squeeze the handle, open, close. Squeeze the handle, open, close. And keep your reservoir in eyesight. I hope that's called eyesight. Hey, nice place. Now. Ooh, a lot of bubbles coming out. And coffee alike, brake fluid, not good. Okay, some more. Hop, open, close. Press a few times till you feel enough pressure on the handle. And then open, close. A few times, open, close. Squeeze, open. It nicely horizontal. Well, this is horizontal. Okay, then I'm gonna do open close. Now I see already clear brake fluid coming through. So, now, carefully, so you can see it. That's the reason why I turn it a bit. So, now, then, hold your straight up. Okay. Just homemade this, it works great. You got officially brake bleeding kits. But this is home. I do have a vacuum pump. When it's all empty, I use the vacuum pump to suck the brake fluid through the lines. That goes quicker. So, even kijken, then close it, okay, clean it, so, okay, then we make another. In. Okay, I will leave that for a while. So, Now, yes, over here. Now let's see. Oops. So guys, now I'm going to show you a trick. But that only works if you have a... no. You can do it on your center stand. Although, it's a low one. So perhaps you need to put a piece of wood underneath your center stand. So you can lift your front wheel off the ground. But in my case, yes. Yeah, I have my winch. Yes. Now, to see if the calipers aren't sticking, these are fantastic. You slightly hear the brake pads onto the discs, but that's normal. But this one's really great. So they retract perfectly. So, if you have a sticking piston in your caliper, you squeeze it and then it's really tight. This is great. Now, we're gonna lower it again. Before I'm gonna fill it up to max level, I like to clean this stuff first. It was terrible. Watch. Whoa. Not good, guys. Not good. Watch. See, all the paint is coming off. I'm gonna use a bit of petrol to clean it better. Now watch. Think I'm gonna do that over there. Ah, this is terrible. First, we're gonna use this one. Okay, then we take screwdriver. If you clean this just every now and then, your bike stays in perfect condition. Believe me. The aluminium is all corroded. Get that white powder. Be sure those tiny, there is a tiny slit over here. To get air above the diaphragm, the membrane, I don't know how you call it. So, wow, it's better. Yeah, could go on forever, but this will do. Now watch. The difference. There is some paint over here, but the membrane goes over there. Now we got this. Watch. Look what I did. It's great. Now we go to the bike again. Now in. Okay, I'm gonna fill it. I usually fill it not to the bare max, as when you put your membrane in, fluid starts pushing out, and we don't want that. So now it's very easy. Get your cap, this thing. Another tip from the old mechanic. The screws, those two, give them a dab of grease. Then you are sure, in time, over years, you can still screw them out. No problem at all. Now, guys, here we go. Then we take the screw and we give them a nice black grease up. They tend to rust, and then over time you can't get them out. Hop. Tight, but not too tight. Just enough. Enough is enough. Give them a clean. An extra bonus tip from the old mechanic. Your bike are gonna love it. And it's easy. Costs barely nothing. Get the brake handle off. This is a 10 mil. Of, yeah, 10 wrench. Get the bottom screw out. Hop. Then this is the wrong one. This is an Allen key of 5 mil. Then hopefully, yes. Now let's see what this is. Don't think it's really great, but we'll see. Sort of feel. This is really something so easy, and it's so great to do it with such. Yeah, you feel the difference. I think this has never been done. Hop, hop, hop. See? Wow. Carefully for a spring. Might drop out. Beautiful drop out. Ta-da. Oh. Yeah. There's a piece of wood. Now, we're gonna give this a clean with petrol too. Here I got my petrol. This one out. The old grease out. Whoa. This is the bushing out too. Give it a really good clean. All that old sticky, filthy grease. So. So. How easy this is. Now this looks great. Then we take that wonderful bushing. Okay. It never seen any grease. No. They only did something here. So. Nice. Well done, old mechanic. Then, guys, we're gonna clean it. Of course, there's petrol onto it now. So. Then, we take a bit of a petrol. Give this one here a nice clean too. Never done that, so. If I have a look into it, okay, yeah, much better. Now, okay, up, yep, what? Now guys, I have here a little plastic thing. And this is EP2 grease. That's grease for these kind of applications. So not like wheel bearing grease, which rotate very fast. This is more for a steering stem, which, and it's grease that you can't push out of the way. Well, look it up, EP2. Extra pressure or extreme pressure, not sure how they, what it stands for. Give it a nice dab, slide it in. Okay, then over here and over there. And then I like to do it on the switch. Okay. And where the brake piston, gonna give that a dab too, then to be sure gonna grease on this side and on that side. Now to keep the spring in place, I always put a tiny bit of grease, so now it stays in place. Then watch where the spring goes in, is a tiny hole thing, it's hop, yes, so easy, so very easy this. Now, much, much better. Then our nut, old mechanic, it's not a bolt, it's a nut, U-nut. Make myself easy with a ratchet, okay. Now we're gonna block the Allen screw bolt. Hop. Feel if it's not too tight. Perfect. This one out. Clean rubber cap black back in place. Okay, other side. Up, 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 up. Okay. So guys, this was my video about doing a front brake oil change on a Yamaha VMAX. Was it easy? Can you do it? I'm sure. With my video and a few tools, my hints and tips, what to look for, all the do's and don'ts, you can do it yourself. Absolute sure. Saves you a lot of money, and that's what my channel is all about. Showing you how easy maintenance on a motorcycle really is. And it is easy. And if you like my channel, well, consider a subscription. Give me thumbs up. All the YouTubers say, yell, hey, thumbs up, thumbs up. So, give me thumbs up. And for now, Old Mechanic, out.